It's November 5th. I got Jason Smith behind the camera. Luckily for me, he filled his buck tag already. John Royer filmed him. So I got a cameraman for the day. It's Monday. I got a couple days off here. Jason's got a couple days off. Reed and Toth are out on this morning. I believe Trevor's out this morning also with Nick McCauley. So we got a bunch of cameras out in the woods filming guys. It should be just coming up to almost full blown right here, November 5th, like I said. Over the weekend, didn't see much chasing. Rut activity's kind of low. But I did see a couple nice bucks on their feet at noon. Hear that? Noon, 1 o'clock. We might have deer coming already. Hear something walking back here, but stay tuned. Hopefully some stuff picks up for us here. We're in a saddle. Got a big hollow, brushy hollow behind us. Got a big brushy hollow kind of running perpendicular to us here. And a brushy field above us that they like to come down off all right into this saddle. So hopefully Mr. Brink steps in the picture here.
there.
Same stand, and I flipping blew it on this morning. Went back, watched it on the TV. I'd like to see it either a little higher to kill the deer or a little bit lower. So we came back, checked for blood. There's nothing, absolutely nothing on my arrow at all. No fat, no slicks of any kind. Went down in the woods, found where he ran down through the woods where the leaves were kicked up. No blood at all. And tell you the truth, we might have seen that same buck a couple hollows over from where we're at now, walking back in. But things calmed down quite a bit there. Around 10 o'clock right after I got shot, that deer. And it's 1 o'clock, 1:30 probably, 2. It's 2 o'clock. We're back in the stand and we're just be here till dark. Only ever hunted one other time in the evening and didn't see much, but all the activity we had this morning, figured it'd be a good spot to be. We'll see what happens. Stick around.
It's Saturday, 6 week archery season. Last night I hit a buck, didn't have a camera with me. Everybody's kind of out trying to fill their tag the last couple days here. But the buck I hit him back through the paunch. Wasn't the best of shots. I was leaning under a branch that was in the way. And he was walking and I shot to the right a little bit. But we should find him. It looked like, as far as up and down from belly to back, it was close to halfway up the body. So I got Dad with me this morning. We're gonna start looking. A couple of the guys offered to come help. I told them to go hunt. If we can't find them, we'll have them come and help. But we just got rain an hour before daylight. I wanted to let them go all night, and then the rain might have hosed us here. But we're gonna see if we can't see anything here. Rolling.
Yep.
Well, like I said last night, Friday night, 6 week of season, it was hot out and real quiet, super quiet. Leaves were real dry and it wasn't going to be a real good night for deer movement, I didn't think. And this buck come rolling down off the hill right down past the tree stand, kind of scared me a little bit. And then he came within range about the last opportunity I was gonna get. And I had to bend down and I was shooting under a limb and I shot to the right, took him through the paunch, and just backed out, let him go all night long, and he's only 100 yards from where I shot him.
We get up at 6 o'clock this morning and it's raining.
Yeah, it rained and I was just jacked, I guess is the best word I can use. I thought we got screwed, but did the best thing we could, backed out. And my 2012 buck season is over. I'm very tickled. Got myself probably a 14, 15 inch buck here. I'd say 15. 9, 9.5 inch G2s. Probably six inch threes. Smith filmed me miss this buck 5 days prior. On my vacation, I had 3 days off. I got to hunt. Did not have the video camera with me last night. Everybody's out trying to fill their buck tag here the last couple days. But I just just meant to get this buck. That's all there is to it for him to come rolling by and get another chance. And I want to thank Dad for coming with me this morning. And
oh, I wouldn't have missed it.
God is good. He's treated me very well. And I can't thank him enough. Thanks to all you people that watch our videos. We're very passionate about being out in the outdoors. We love it very much. What I'm shooting here, I bought this bow at Calversport Rendezvous Traditional Archery Shoot. The guys from Bob Lee down in Texas come up, and I was shooting their Bob Lee Hunter Recurve series before this bow, and I only took a couple hundred bucks with me because I didn't want to spend a lot of money while I was there. Well, they have bows there that let you shoot, and I picked this bow up. It's a Bob Lee Exotic. I believe it's called a Reflex Deflex. I started shooting it, and I wasn't supposed to drive up. We ended up having rain, and I had a tonneau cover on my truck to keep our gear dry. Well, I had my checkbook in the truck, which is a bad mistake, and I came home with this, and it's a very nice shooting bow. Target shooting, I normally am pretty good with it, but normally when I'm bent down, shooting under, not good form, twisted around, you bow hunters know how it goes sometimes. I pulled to the right, and that's what I did last night. He was walking when I shot also, right to left. But as long as you do the right thing, back out, even if you do take him through the center of the paunch, chances are you're going to find him. But shooting gold tip arrows, 35-55s. They're cut to 30 inches, 100 grain brass inserts. And then I'm shooting Magnus Stinger 2-blade broadheads. Very super sharp broadhead, real easy to get sharp again. So
can't stress enough, backing out is a marginal hit, and this buck is maybe 100-120 yards from where he was last night. I mean, Hunter said last night he heard him stop out here, and we were hoping that he laid down, which is what they do a lot of times with a hit like that. But if we would have tried to follow this deer last night, we would have jumped him, and who knows where he would have ended up, and he would have been very hard to track. So you just can't stress enough, learn anything from this. If you know you put a marginal hit on him, just back out. Go the next morning if you can. But
8 to 10 hours.
Yeah.
Normally what we try to do. And I hit him right before dark last night, so we just waited until this morning.
It worked out. Nothing went to waste.
He's not hurt from me missing him in the video. He looks like it's kind of close to actually catching the bottom of his paunch. But, I mean, no doubt about it, same buck, acorn and the antler. He was up and fine for another 4 days chasing and breeding does.
Yeah, you can see that in the first video. That right beam right there had an acorn out the end of it. And he said last night that it possibly could be the same buck. He was pretty sure of it. And there he is. So thumbs up for you.
2012. Can't be happier.
Yep. Good job, bud.